Means visibility is clear. Mitali Agrawal?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we will be seeing traffic signal problem. I'll be giving you the view of the traffic signal problem, and you will understand through which complexity you will be going through. Though you might have seen or understood that this problem is a very simple problem, but by seeing the view of simulation model which is developed and which finally will be reaching to after certain explanation, you will understand that that problem is not that simple, nor it is complex too. Okay, so before the things load, let's not take the break. So simulation problem, this signal problem is not just the signal problem. It will also be representing the manufacturing situation in the industry. Rather, this simulator is basically meant for manufacturing simulation. But you find that there are many situations where there is no manufacturing, but there is a content of simulation. We can simulate that situation. For example, in bank, there is no manufacturing. At traffic signal, there is no manufacturing. But we can map what happens at the signal. We can map what happens in the bank post office with what happens in the industry, manufacturing. Okay. In this simulation, particularly student edition, we have few building blocks by using which we have to form the simulation model. And what are those building blocks? There will be starting point. There will be queue. Queue signifies that there is certain waiting there. Why there is waiting? Because the facility which will be working is busy. So work item cannot enter into that facility. So there must be a queue. Then there is activity. Activity is signified by some machining or something for which will hold up the work item. Right? Then there is end. Like there is a start point, there will be end. Then there is resource. Resource means for performing certain activity, sometimes some resource or some resources will be required. Right? Just a minute. Some resources will be required. And all these entities which you are saying, start point, queue, activity, and resource, will be connected by routing arrows. Okay. So with this entities, you have to form the simulation model. All these entities in the building block will be available in the manufacturing situation. This is what you have to build. By looking at this, you must be feeling that this is really complex thing. You will be feeling whether we will be in position to build this complex model. Okay, this is not that complex. I will just remove the complexity from this model, and you will feel that it is very simple. It has a complex look because of so many routing arrows. There are so many routing arrows. Okay, I will just explain what happens in the signal. Some vehicles are coming from this side. Here is the signal. then some of the vehicles will be going this side, that is left side. Some of the vehicle will be going to right side, and some of the vehicles will be going straight. This thing is repeated from all four directions. That's why it is having complex look. I will simplify the look of the model, and then you will start feeling that it is simple. Okay, it at times is very important to take out the routing arrows from our scene, and how that is done. You just keep on observing motions of the cursor and what I am clicking, because whenever you will be seeing this video next time, you will have to observe that only. Right here, I am clicking on this one routing icon. You click, you just don't click on this routing icon, you just click the arrowhead just beside it. Here. Then there are two options coming. Always show routing arrows, show resource routes. Okay. We are not using resources in this model. Okay. You will be learning those how to use resources in some other practical. We are using routing arrows. So always show routing arrows. We don't want to show routing arrows. I have clicked it. Okay. Why it is not going out? It should have gone. All these arrows should have gone. Yeah. Now, are you seeing it very clean? Okay. Now you might not be feeling that it is complex, because what is there? There is only a square, and this is the divider line, and this is all the arrangement. These are some of the components which will be required to be there for simulating the model. Okay. Now, what are the components? Okay. The components, just look at here. Components of traffic signal. If I want to simulate this, there must be a square. So here, there is a square. Okay, we'll have to square like figure. Okay, square like figure won't be there in your simulate. Okay, simulate. Square you will have to draw, otherwise you won't know what is happening where. Okay, if you want to simulate certain production process in the industry, it is always advised to have the layout of the industry. You draw it in your paint shop or some drafting software, and that you can call in your simulate. How that is done, that I'll show you. Okay. So just see here. Why to make the thing late? I will be showing what I did during the development. Okay. So search. I want to show that I have drawn a signal in the paint shop. Paint. So your layout, you may draw, if you are trying to simulate certain industry operation, then you will have to ask the industry personnel about the layout of the industry. You will be drawing that layout in the paint, or you may draw it in AutoCAD or whichever compatible software you find, you can draw that in. Okay, Yes, I think I have. Do I have the square? I have taken it. No, no. So all in all, you will be drawing a square here. It's JPG basically. Okay. You just take a new drawing, and here by taking the lines from here, you will be drawing a square. For drawing straight line, then from here, you just you know, you have these skills better. From this side, you draw it like this, then like this, you will be drawing the square. That's what I did. Okay. Then next thing, the square will be having four openings, and from these openings, vehicles will be coming from all sides. They will be coming randomly. You won't have control on vehicles coming to the square. And their arrival normally follow Poisson distribution with different mean, okay, right? And that mean you will be specifying in your simulation model as here. Just a minute. Okay, from all four sides, vehicles will be coming with different arrival rate. Okay, but they will be generating randomly. So second element is vehicle. Okay, this vehicle in general, in language of simulate, it is called as work item. Item which flows through various processes. It is called as work item. So on these vehicles, we don't have much control. Then there is third entity involved in this simulation, and that is signal system. Here you are having this as signal. Okay. Now you know how the signal operate. One will be green and rest other will be red. All right. We have seen this in the morning. Right. So first of all, we will have to go on developing one by one. This systems one by one. Okay. So our primary concern here is how these signals will be in sequence, will be getting, one will be green, and then after certain time, other will be green, rest other will be red. Earlier, which was green, will now turn to red. This will turn to green. Okay. Then after some time, this will turn to red and this will turn to green. And likewise, the things will continue. Okay. You will be given that for how much time each signal glows green. Okay, that timing will be given to you, or you will have to assume it, or the system may generate it. All right. So first of all, we will be interested in forming simulation of the signals only. Okay. So just look here. These are the signals. But you won't understand this, how they are operating. Because I have hidden all the routing arrows. which I will make them visible. Just by clicking there, routing arrows have become visible. Or if they don't become visible, you just click here and always show, you just tick it. Okay. Now, just beside, I will be drawing this model very fast. For that, just I take a starting point here. Then I take, see, remember always, whenever there is activity, it is always a good practice to have the cue before that activity. Okay, you don't connect activity with activity. You don't connect the start point with activity. You better have the cue before the activity, because that activity will be processing certain work item, and in that case, the work item should not directly enter into that activity or machine. To avoid that, you must have a buffer or storage or a queue just before the activity. So here I have the start point, then I will take a queue. Okay. Sometimes this get directly joined and sometimes they don't get joined. We will be joining them later. Then activity. Default picture, default image for this activity will be like this. Okay. Then after this, once again, it will, this activity is signifying what is called as a signal. It is a machine for us. Okay. Then after this, there will be once again the activity, again the signal. Then once again, there will be a queue. And there will be an activity. Okay, here it is. And once again, there will be a queue and the activity. Okay. And after that, there will be exit point, end point, right? Now we'll be joining all this. I'll not be beautifying whole this as I have beautified this, that you can always do. Now you have to connect all of this by routing arrows. What you need to do, you just click on edit routing arrow, and the arrow cursor, you just click on the point from where you have to draw the arrow and take it to the object or component to where you have to draw the arrow. That arrow will become big. That signifies that the arrow will become, arrowhead will end there. Once again, you click here and click here, that will get joined. Click here, click here, click here, click here, then click here, click here, then click here and click here. This route is showing the flow in which the work item will be moving. Here you click and here then you click. Then here you click, then here you click, and then here to here. Okay, positioning task you can always do. One thing I'll be specifically interested to end this arrow mode, you just click this once again. Edit routing arrows once again. Sometimes you now look at how I have bent this arrow. For doing that, you click on the arrow. And then you just take it like this. Click on the arrow, then you press, you drag it by mouse. I cannot show my action to you. Okay, dragging means pressing one of the button and moving your mouse. Right? So this is how. And suppose say you want to cancel this bent arrow. So you just click on the arrow which is bent and click a delete button. It will become straight. Right? You can bend it on multiple points. Like here. So say you want to bend it here. You can do that right here. Okay, I am clicking on the portion of the arrow and then dragging it further. See, it has been done like this. Okay. Now you just run this model. Okay, there are two ways by which you just click here, but before running, you make it a practice that you reset the thing. Okay, you reset, or you may go to home, and there are again the same buttons available. All right? Okay, now run. You look at this. I want to have this kind of, you look at this figure. I want to have that kind of effect here. Work items are flowing properly. But the effect of changing of color is not actually changing of color. It is changing of image. Okay. The changing of color will be requiring intricate programming. Okay, that is avoided here. Instead, what is done in Simulate, you change the graphics. It is not change of color. You see that this image and this image look different. Green color, okay? So, it is now, I have to change the graphic. Okay? Before that, nominally, some properties I'll be changing. For changing the properties, you have to stop running, better reset, right? Reset is not mandatory, but it is good practice. You see the properties of this, what I have said, fixed, entry I am taking, inter-arrival time of two work items, I have given 60 seconds. Here actually, I am now recalling, I have not given seconds. I am working on this model in terms of minutes. You will be changing it to seconds. Whenever you will be building your model, you will be turning it to seconds. So, inter-arrival time is 60. Okay, right, then from this means two work items will be coming with a gap of 60 seconds, right? Now this signal has to glow green for 15 seconds. And has to remain red for 45 seconds because your time for every signal I have given 15 seconds. This will glow green for 15, this will glow green for 15, this and this also will glow green for 15 seconds. Okay, you can change these times. But for your preliminary model and for understanding, it is better to have similar timing. Later on, you can change the time. See here, what are the timings? Okay. Here there are two things. This is very important issue. I must discuss on it. Okay. There are two issues. One is signal should glow green for 15 seconds. This parallelly means in this system that signal should remain red for 45 seconds. Remaining red means it is doing something. There is some processing going on. This machine is busy for 45 seconds. This is signifying activity timing. So I am not giving, I should not give, there is no place for me to give idle time whenever I am setting the properties. I have to give the activity time. So you might wonder why I have not written here for 15 seconds. Because 15 seconds is the time for which this signal will not be working. Means it will be free. It will be allowing everything from this side to cross through. Right? So I have to give the working time here, activity time. Okay, so I have given 45 seconds. And the two items are coming with a gap of 60 seconds. Okay, and this machine, this signal is processing post work item for 45 seconds. That means this signal is busy for, this machine is busy for 45 seconds. That means it is free for 15 seconds. Okay, this logic you will have to build initially. Sometimes whatever data is available to you, you will be directly using it or you will have to process it. So I hope you have understood it. If not, you will be taking your own time to understand. And if you have still the problem, all of you have the problem, then we will be having one more discussion on it. So every activity, the distribution I have sent set to fixed, and fixed the value, that is activity duration 45. This also to 45, this also to 45. So I am sure that this also is one of the way of doing this settings. Okay, fixed value means you can set the distribution from here, and the fixed, the value you can set here. Okay, right now as I have opened this, I'll be taking a little time to explain many of the things from this dialog box. Okay, this dialog box is available for every component. Okay, in this dialog box there are two buttons which will rescue you out of this dialog box. I'm not able to do anything on this screen because this dialog box is present here. Now if I want to do something on this screen, I either have to press OK or cancel button. Okay, you have to be cautious while pressing OK or cancel button. If you press cancel, then whatever changes you have made in terms of setting up the property will get lost. So you decide whether you want to you want to get away from all those changes or you want to save the changes. If you want to save the changes, click OK. Okay, so here I am clicking properties button. Here you will be entering the values. These two buttons I have just explained. Third button, help. If you get stuck up, you will be clicking help. This help button is not much helpful. It doesn't provide much of the help to you. Okay, because it doesn't know, it is not that smart to know what is your problem, where are you stuck up. So it will be giving you general kind of help, so don't depend much on it. Then memo is for documentation, something you want to write about it, then you can write some lines there. Okay, if you want to know what this memo does, you just play the cursor on this button. Besides, you will see what it does. The memo button lets you add notes and documentation. Okay, so it will be very specific to you. Okay, like when you make your model, then you will have your own documentation. Someone else will have his own documentation. Some doubts also can be written there, okay? Or some logics also can be written there, okay? In descriptive form, result button, okay? Now suppose say I have run this model for some time. I have run this model for managing the speed. You can better come to home, but while this model is running, you don't try to manipulate the speed. Many times, because of manipulating the speed while the model is running, the simulate hangs. So you better pause it and increase the speed, and then once again run it. Okay, it will run at faster mode. Now stop here. Oh, here you click right mouse, click properties, and after you click properties, come to results. You will be shown things specific to entry points. It will show here that three items have entered and three work items were generated and three items entered into the simulation. Okay, so whichever point you want to have the result, for example, here I'll click the properties and I'll click the results. Okay, so it will show me various things which are significant to that particular activity. I won't be discussing much on that. You see and understand, because we want to have this session short. Might be in today's class, whole of the things may not get covered. Tomorrow also, even though there is a holiday, I want you to learn how to make your traffic signal square. Okay, simulation of traffic signal square. So that will be possible for you after understanding all these things. Okay, while I am explaining the traffic signal simulation model, I am explaining you the things which are coming in my way. So far we have seen 1, 2, that is okay button, cancel button, help button, memo button, result button, resources button. I won't be explaining now because this is no resource is used in this model. Efficiency also I will not be explaining. I will be finding some of the problem wherein these two things come. Then there is routing in. Routing in stands for example, this arrow signifies routing out from entry point. And this arrow is routing into this queue. This queue has routing in also and routing out also. Okay. And there is one more button which is important, that is actions. So in your simulation, these three things will happen to be very important. Okay, rather four things. One is routing in, routing out, then actions, then graphics. And these things are otherwise available somewhere or other. Okay, so you remember, for good simulation, reasonably better simulation, you will have to master routing in, routing out, action and graphics. Okay, now I'll take you into routing in. Okay, I'll cancel this. Let's come here. Okay, just here. Okay, come here, routing in. Properties and routing. There is only routing out there. There is no question of routing in at a entry point. Okay. So there are so many things which occur in various scenarios. There will be circulation. There will be uniform. There will be percent. There will be priority. There will be label. Label thing will be specifically seeing in this problem, but not now. Okay, shortest queue, job matrix, all these things you have to understand. But all of them will not be seeing right now. As and when we come across the things, we will understand them. Okay, right? So right now, I don't have any need of routing out here. There is automatic routing out. Okay, default routing out is always there. Okay, now it will enter in here. You just think whether I have any requirements, specific thing to be achieved when some work item comes here. Okay, or goes out from here. I don't think I have anything. Okay, but one thing I am sure that I need to set the property of this, that the distribution is fixed and the inter arrival time is 60. This is in minutes. Later on, we'll be changing it to seconds. How to do that? We will be seeing later. Now, timing not, let us not divert to that. Okay? You can change it to hours, you can change it to days, and likewise, you can change it to seconds as well. So 60 is the inter-arrival time between two arrivals, and that is fixed. Okay. Initially, when you develop the model, everything you should keep fixed, no distribution. Okay. You should create deterministic model initially, so that you can debug it. You will be knowing the way model works. Okay. Okay then. Here, come here. I don't have any specific requirement for this thing. Only this queue is infinite. Okay, that you can either set here or here in the properties. Okay, only two settings are important for me. The queue is infinite. And there is no shelf life. Because this model is a simulation software is developed for taking care of various things. So there are some things, some items which expire after certain time. There is shelf life. Okay. And there are some items which will have to wait for some time. Okay. For example, some item is placed in furnace. Okay. You can include that in machining time, or you can include that in waiting time. Okay. So here I simply need queue is infinite and there is no shelf life. Okay. And that is true with everything, every queue. Now come here. Activity. Now initially in the beginning, I would like to have all my machines to look different. So I'll take you to graphics. In this particular simulation model, I don't need routing in, routing out logic and even the actions logic. There will be some specific situation wherein this will be required. Now I'll be coming to graphics because I want to change the graphics. I'm coming to graphics here. or just click here. And after clicking, there are multiple interfaces where you can change the graphic. Okay, here you go to library. After you go to library, it will take you to default library, or you may have specific location where you would have stored some of the images. Okay, so work items I'll be taking you to. Do I have the image of that red ball and green ball? No, I don't. These are work items. Work items are different. The work items in our case will be vehicles. Okay, here I won't be using this. I better use these balls for signifying for you for work items. Okay. So let's go at some different place. Okay, where do I have? I have that in documents. I have stored those images in documents. So you will be having your own directory. Documents here. In the documents, image files, it is a music clicked. I want documents. Okay. Traffic signal JPG. I was showing you this thing which I created in paint, and I have taken that image here. Okay, then coming on to simulation, these are the two images which I created in paint, saved as JPG and saved at the location where all images I am going to save. So let's click here, green, open, okay, and click OK. Okay, and click OK. This will turn green. Okay. Now, similar way, this also. I want to turn, but I cannot do anything here. I'll close this here, then I'll click here and I'll go to properties, and I'll go to graphics, and then I'll go to pictures. You have to find out where to click. See, these people develop the software and they expect us to explore it as per the way it was while they had that in their mind while they developed. Okay, that is what he is learning to work on the software. Here I click again, and here I click on the library. Okay. And now again green. Okay, open, okay, and okay. And here again. But here again you forget that there was something which I haven't closed. Close it. And here. Open the properties. There might be some shortcuts, but I want you to explore these shortcuts and tell those shortcuts to me later on. Again, go to graphics. The student edition doesn't allow you to change the properties, set the properties in group. Professional edition allows you to select multiple objects and set their common properties. Okay, so had this been professional edition, so in one go, I would have changed the properties of all the activities. Okay, so anyway, here I have to do that again and again. But once that is set in hand, you can do it fast. Then it is okay, and close, okay. And here, okay. Properties, and then graphics. Okay, then. Image. And library. See, these various things are jumbled. And you have to find which of this will be helpful to me. Okay, everything you don't understand by reading the help or referring the help. You have to do guesswork many times. Okay here, then okay here, and then okay here. Okay. So we have come pretty close to this one. Okay, if I bend certain arrows and place the activities and cues, it will look like this. Okay, I won't spend time in that. But now the question is, how will this turn red? Okay, before doing that, you just give the time to your brain, just let it run and see whether it is working fine or not. Yes, it is working, but only the difference is the color is not changing. Color means what? Graphics again. Okay. Or you may have to refer to routing in logic. Okay, but in this simulation, I don't need any routing in logic. In the bigger simulation of traffic signal, I'll be needing. That time you will be understanding how to use routing in logic, routing out logic, etc. So come here, see the properties. You come here, go here, then graphics. There are some things which we have ignored. Now here they ask, what should be the graphics when this item is working, this machine is working? I know that it should be red when this machine is working. Okay, how should be the graphics when this machine is blocked or stopped? You have various facilities already available here. So I simply want that when this graphic should turn red to a red ball when there is some work item or this machine is engaged with work item. Here work item means vehicle. Okay, so the certain item will be coming here and will be staying there for 45 seconds. Until 45 seconds, this signal should turn red. What do I do? Click working there. And after frequent use of these icons, machine icons, machine images, that machine images will form the part of this list. The red. Okay, red. It will turn red. Right now, it hasn't turned red. But whenever work item will come there, it will turn red. And same thing I have to do at other places. Okay? So here. Where? Properties. Okay. Because I have to do the things frequently, that will help you to understand where is what. Okay, here you go. You have used earlier this for changing the icon. Now you use this, or that time itself, if you are practiced enough, then while changing the icon, you will do this also. That would have saved a lot of your time. But because it was your first time, you would not have done that. Here you come. Properties. And then graphics. And then working. When it is working, it should turn red. Okay. Might be different, might be there are different machines will be giving different colors. But we are stuck up in the signal problem. Okay. You just imagine what look, the signals will be looking beautiful if there are different shades of red on different sides. Okay. And lastly, this one. Okay, but that won't work until you close it for previous. Here you click. Once it is selected, click properties. And after clicking properties, you click graphics. And click working. And then red. Okay, and I think I am done. Okay, except for the placement of the components in this, rest of the thing it is same. Now let's run. I'll decrease the speed also so that you see the changes. Changes are visible to you. Okay. Yeah, turned red and red and no. There is some problem. This is not turning red. Have you seen it turning red any time? It has turned red even though the work item has gone here, but it has not turned red. So let's stop this and check whether we have saved the graphic for this. Go to properties. Why it is taking graphics? And I have said the time. What is wrong? Working and read. Okay. Then there must be some problem. Yeah, there is a problem because I have set the timing for this very small, fixed and 45 I should have set for it. Okay. Now just understand here what is happening. Okay, now it will turn red and show red for significant amount of time. This signal is closed and it will remain closed for 45 seconds and open for 15 seconds. How it will be open for 15 seconds? Because initially you won't believe that it is open for 15 seconds, but as the model warms up, so there is a concept of warming up. Because initially, many of the things are on border of starting. Once the model has, everything has started enough, and might be 4-5 cycles have completed, then only the data should be collected. First 4-5 times data or 10 data are of no meaning. Okay, so this was the signal system. I said to you there are three systems. One is the square, which I have shown to you. Just look at here. I have created a painting in the paint, that I have shown to you in documents. It is, where is that? JPG, JPG. Okay. Just last 5 minutes, we'll be stopping. Then with this much of backing, and I need you to practice. All right? Simply this signal. There are no many things there. Okay, so where is the traffic? JPG. Traffic signal. No. This one. So one entity in the simulation model is a traffic signal, a traffic square. Second is traffic signal. And the third is the traffic coming from, vehicles coming from four sides. Okay. So for your reference, I am giving you this page. I'll be showing. You may see this image of the square I created in paint. Now I know the my working area whenever I'll be building my simulation model. Just look at it here. Okay. This square. Now you may wonder, how did I bring this square here? Okay. So just look. I'll be stopping this and I'll be creating a new model just to bring that signal here. Okay, just a minute. File, then new, blank simulation. It always will be asking to save the changes of previous simulation, and that is good to save. Okay. Then there is the insert button over here in the menu. Okay. You click in on insert here, and then background image. There are many things which you can insert. Okay. One by one, you will explore those things yourself. Once you know how one thing get inserted, background image. Okay. Now what will happen? It will ask me from where to bring that image. So dialog box will appear. Okay. Once I click. Okay. My image is. In the location, you must know, okay, for me, it is in documents and in here, traffic square, okay, open, all right, now, this is a very big image, so for making it small, you just zoom it in. Okay, now what you can do, you can move it like this one. I'm sorry. Okay, and there is one more thing. Just right click here, and if you want to have a grid, right now it has been plain, you just show grid. Okay, now if you want to move, okay, it's not moving. Yeah, now it will. You click on the border, you can take these images anywhere you want. Okay. I don't have proper mouse, that's why it is taking a little time. Okay, anyway, now in this everything which you want to place out of this building blocks, start point you will be placing here. Okay, why you will be placing it here? Okay, now you need to understand signals very clearly, whether you will be placing it here or here. Okay, which side will be entry side? Okay, this is the entry side, not this one. Okay, you will have to decide one entry side, then some mechanism you will have to create here, because of which entering vehicles will stop. Okay, whenever the signal glows red. Okay, this thing we will be stopping here. As we go on talking about various things in simulate, that should create curiosity within your mind, that I should try something on my own. Okay, because you don't have to purchase anything. You don't have to purchase any machine, you don't have to purchase any vehicle, everything you can drag and drop here. And you can connect them and you can see them working. Okay? So, I'll be showing you the signal picture. Okay? Which involved, which I have, this is the signal system which we have discussed just now. This is entry point, this is cue, this is the signal in the square, this is again the cue, this is the signal, this is again the cue, this is the signal, this is again the cue, and this is the signal, and this is exit. Items are coming every 60 seconds and traveling through in a systematic manner, and the item is getting lost to environment. Again, new item is coming and it is going. This item, actually item is not needed very much there, because we are not producing anything but just for showing the engagement and making this signal red and green. I have to map it against the, what I say, production process, manufacturing process. Everything which you come across, you see, you find it's manufacturing equivalent. And if you are able to find its manufacturing equivalent, you will be able to simulate that thing. Even if it is a service, still there is a manufacturing equivalent. Okay? So, we will stop here for today. Recording I'll be sending to all of you. Okay? And tomorrow, once again, we will this lecture. And all what I am discussing is the part of practical as well as theory. Okay? There might be a question in exam to design the traffic signal model. Let me not be very specific. It might be some other system model in simulate. Okay, might be one or two questions on it. Alright? Lastly, a short feedback. Where are you? Yeah, Mitali?
Yes, sir.
Do you think that after going through this lecture once again, you will be able to form that signal model? Signal,
yes,
only
sir.
Signals changing their colors in sequence. Okay?
I have made it.
You made it. Wonderful. Okay.
Yes, sir. I'm glad you did.
Yeah. Hello. हाँ सर, 5 मिनट में मेरा लेक्चर खत्म हो रहा है। हाँ, आ रहा है। I am really impressed. Now you just take out the snap. Okay, it is getting recorded. This is one important page which will help you through, because I have written something, so it becomes your duty to read it. Okay, then there are some questions which will happen to be important while you have your initial attempts of learning. Okay, and then this was for developing the logic. We can look at the problem of signal in two ways. Signal glows green for 15 seconds, whether to model for it, or it glows red for 45 seconds, whether to model for this. So we have modeled it for signal glowing red for 45 seconds. This thing we'll be seeing tomorrow. Everyone present? Yeah, attendance? Yes, Booty.
Present, sir.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
You WhatsApp me the attendance. WhatsApp Chakpali was, sir, the attendance of this class.
Sure, sir.
Anyone has any doubt?
Sir, can we please get the attendance of 1.5 hours?
Yeah. Attendance?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Lux, kya bol raha? Yes. So should we hang out here? हाँ, कृष्णा चतुर्वेदी, अमन, आगे भी करना है? ने जो मैं कल बताने वाला हूँ उसमें अगर आपने बहुत कुछ आगे कर लिया, आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी. एंड सिमुलेशन कोर्स विल कंटिन्यू even after your exam is over, because this is something which will get you the job. Okay, so we'll stop here.